돌리겠다.
저도
나이스 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 나이스.
Make this game mode permanent in Siege. This is me, Ashik, and today I want to talk about why Ubisoft must make Showdown event as permanent. For those of you don't know, Showdown was a weekend arcade event where you enter a custom cowboy map in a 3 squad and play against other 3 players. As attackers, you are the police or the sheriffs of the Wild West, and as defenders, you are bandits or dacoits protecting your booty. Coming back to the topic, at present, it is the best time to play Siege. Crystal Guard is surprisingly fresh. The new operators, they are fairly balanced. The operator tweaks and the map buffs, they are all well done. However, before this season, I was gravitating towards other games such as Valorant and CSGO. Valorant may look like a mashup between an ability-based shooter and the fast-paced gunplay of CSGO, but it has made its own impression among gamers, and it is thriving on it. If I am being specific, I loved the Team Deathmatch and the Spike Rush game mode in Valorant. These provide instant action and you only have to play for the kills, that's all. You cannot do that in Siege, especially in rank or unrank. Unless you are not playing to win or increase your MMR, chances are that you play rank with a specific strategy in mind. A slight deviation from that strategy will be you losing the match. And that's why Showdown event was the best opportunity to shake things up. But let's do a rundown why I think arcade game modes must become as permanent game modes. Number 1. The sweat in rank. You cannot deny that rank matches can go from fun to a serious situation where half of your teammates will make your ears bleed. You have to bring certain operators to a certain job, you need a Jaeger to help your smoke, you need a Thermite or a Hibana, you need a Mute, and you need a Flank Watcher Nomad. It kind of gets into your skin, and when you play to win, it becomes a job more than a video game. Game modes like Showdown or the Sugar Fright event, these can be a great option to relax. You play 3 rank matches and you lose all of them, maybe take a break and have fun with the fast-paced high-octane Showdown or Sugar Fright. Number 2. The downtime in Siege. Downtime in Siege is high as compared to other shooters. And there is a good reason for it, I agree. But unless you are playing as a team where you discuss the strategies before the next round, you will get bored. If a single rank match goes into the overtime, 35 to 40 minutes of your time is gone. That is too much, to be honest. Again, as I said, dedicated players will not get bored. They will make optimum use of this time. But what about the casual players, the little guys? A new player might just stop playing and head over to other games. Make these game modes permanent, so that casual players can go and relax while also learning the gun mechanics. This way, eventually, they will also try rank and adjust to the whole culture. Number 3. We already have a quick match playlist. I know about the quick match playlist and also the T-Hunt, but compare how much of that fast-paced action you get from it. There still is a preparation phase, there still is an element of that rank match vibes, and on top of that, there are still players who play quick matches with same sweaty attitude. As for my squad, we rush in as attackers and run out as defenders. When we play quick match, we really want it to be quick. Sugar Fright was a good example of this, and it was all just fun. Showdown is a similar event, albeit with the Boss G, a 6-shooter, and a hell lot of yeehaw. Now, to provide a counter argument, these game modes can dilute the highly tactical environment of Siege. I can really see the arcade playlist becoming the community's favorite, if not the more popular than rank or unrank. I totally agree with this point, and I'm sure none of us want this. Also, these game modes are similar to the Rainbow Six X-Defiant game that is coming out maybe this year or the next year, and we all know what the reception for that game was. I will conclude the video at this point, and I will still advocate to make these game modes as permanent in Siege. We can pull the plug on anything that does not work, but Ubisoft should try going this way. They should acknowledge the community's needs. What are your thoughts about this? Tell me in the comment section. I am all ears to listen. If you like the video, please hit the like button, subscribe if you have not, and share it with your friends.